Good morning, dear students. In last lecture, we have already seen fat-soluble vitamins, that is vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. In this lecture, we will start with water-soluble vitamins. These water-soluble vitamins consist of a large number of substances, including B-complex vitamins like thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, etc., and vitamin C. Being a water-soluble vitamin, some of these vitamins will lodge during the cooking. And these water-soluble vitamins cannot be stored in our body because whatever excess amount of these water-soluble vitamins consumed by our body will be excreted through our excretory system. Okay? And because of this, there will be no toxicity of water-soluble vitamins because these vitamins are not stored in our body. Unlike fat-soluble vitamins, because fat-soluble vitamins are stored in our body, they will more likely create toxicity when consumed in excess amount. Okay, then we will see the first water soluble vitamin, that is vitamin B1. Vitamin B1 is also known as the thiamine and rapidly destroyed by heat. Then we will see what are the functions of this vitamin B1 or thiamine. Vitamin B1 acts as a controlling agent in energy metabolism. It is involved in a proper functioning of nerves and muscles. Then we'll see what is the deficiency syndrome of vitamin B1 or thiamine. Beriberi is a deficiency syndrome of vitamin B1 or thiamine. And then we will see symptoms of vitamin B1 deficiency. Affects digestive and nervous system. Loss of appetite, impaired digestion, weakness and numbness. Pain in the legs, irritability, mental depression, confusion and fear. These are the symptoms of deficiency of vitamin B1. Then we will go to the sources of vitamin B1 or thiamine. Whole cereals, legumes, wheat germ, nuts, vegetables, fruits. These are the plant sources of vitamin B1 or thiamine. Then animal sources, meat, fish, milk, these are the animal sources of vitamin B1. Okay. Then we will go to the vitamin B2. It is also known as the riboflavin. This vitamin is slightly soluble in water and stable to heat in acidic condition, but destroyed rapidly in alkaline conditions. Then we will see the functions of riboflavin. Riboflavin acts as a controlling agent in energy metabolism and tissue building. It is also a very vital factor in protein and carbohydrate metabolism. Then we will go to the deficiency of the vitamin B2 or riboflavin. What is the symptoms of deficiency of vitamin B2? Affects oral and facial skin and eyes. Angular stomatitis, cracks at the corner of leaves, eyes become very sensitive to light with itching and burning. These are the important deficiency symptoms of riboflavin. This deficiency syndrome of riboflavin is known as a riboflavinosis. Okay, sometimes it leads to the chelosis, which includes inflammation of lips and tongues. Then we will see what is the sources of this riboflavin or vitamin B2. Whole cereals, legumes, millets, green leafy vegetables, these are the plant sources of riboflavin, while milk and milk products, eggs, organ meat like liver and heart, yeast extract, these are the animal source of the riboflavin. Then we will go to the next vitamin, that is niacin. It is also known as vitamin B3. The precursor of niacin is a tryptophan, which gets converted into the niacin in our body. Niacin is also water-soluble vitamin. It is a fairly stable to acid, heat, alkali, and light and oxidation also. Then we will see what is the function of this niacin. Then we will go to the next vitamin, that is vitamin B3. It is also known as a niacin. The precursor of this niacin is a tryptophan which gets converted into niacin in our body. Niacin is also water-soluble vitamin, but it is a fairly stable to acid, heat, alkaline conditions, light and oxidation also. Then we will see what is the function of vitamin B3 or niacin. It is a very essential for normal function of skin, intestinal tract and nervous system. Niacin is a part of a coenzyme which helps in the carbohydrate, fat and protein metabolism. As you know, coenzyme is a part or compound which helps for optimum functioning of a enzyme. Okay, then we will go to the deficiency symptoms of this vitamin B3 or niacin. Pellagra is a deficiency syndrome of vitamin B3. It is generally known as the disease of Cordes. Why? Because the symptoms of this disease is dermatitis, diarrhea, dementia and death. Okay, then we will see the sources of niacin. What is the plant sources of niacin? Whole cereals, beans, nuts, oil seed. These are the plant sources of the niacin. And meat, fish, poultry, milk and egg. These are the animal sources of the niacin. Okay. Okay, then we will see the next vitamin, that is the vitamin B6 or pyridoxine. Pyridoxine has a very important role in production of red blood cells and conversion of tryptophan into the niacin or vitamin B3. So sometimes if there is a deficiency of vitamin B6, it will lead to the deficiency of niacin or deficiency of vitamin B3. Pyridoxine has a very important role in our building of immunity. It also has an important function in our nervous system. It reduces muscle spasms, cramps and numbness, maintains proper balance of sodium and phosphorus in the body. These are the important functions of pyridoxine. Then we will go to the deficiency symptoms of the pyridoxine. Anemia, depression, confusion, abnormal brain wave patterns, greasy, scaly dermatitis. These are the vitamin B6 deficiency symptoms. Okay. Then we will go to the sources of the vitamin B6 or pyridoxine. Beef liver cooked, that is a very good source of vitamin B6. Banana, sweet potato, baked potato, chicken breast, spinach. These are the very good source of vitamin B6. Then we will go to the next vitamin, that is vitamin B12. It is also known as a cyanocobalamin. The name cyanocobalamin got to this vitamin because it contains cobalt mineral. Okay, then we will see the function of this vitamin B12. It has a very important function. It acts as a coenzyme in the synthesis of new DNA. Thus it helps in the synthesis of new cell. Also it has a very important role in cellular level energy production. Okay, then we will see what are the deficiency symptoms of vitamin B12. Deficiency of vitamin B12 will lead to the anemia, smooth tongue, tingling and numbness, memory loss, disorientation and sometimes degradation of nervous which progress in the paralysis. Okay, then we will see the sources of vitamin B12. Chicken liver, cottage cheese, pork roast, these are the very good source of vitamin B12. Sardines, tuna, Swiss cheese, these are the also source of the vitamin B12. Okay, then we will go to the next vitamin, that is vitamin C. Vitamin C, it is also known as the ascorbic acid. It is the most unstable vitamin as it is easily destroyed by heat, oxygen, alkalis and at high temperature. Okay, then we will see what is the important function of this vitamin C. It is a powerful reducing agent. It helps in a formation of hemoglobin. It also helps in formation of structural proteins that helps in bone, teeth formation and healing wounds. It has a very important role in activation of many enzymes. It increases resistance to the diseases, means it boosts the immunity of a human being or animals. Okay, it helps for better absorption of iron. Okay, then we will see what is the deficiency symptoms of vitamin C. As you know, Scurvy is a deficiency syndrome of vitamin C. The symptoms of deficiency of vitamin C is a general weakness, shooting joint pains, then anemia, infections, poor wound healing, spongy bleeding gums, and rough and dry skin. These are the general symptoms of deficiency of vitamin C. Okay, then we will see the source of vitamin C. Citrus fruit are the richest sources of vitamin C. It is found abundantly in all citrus family. Best source of vitamin C is amla. Okay, then other sources are guava, pear, orange, green leafy vegetables, sprouted pulses are also very good source of vitamin C or ascorbic acid. Okay, it is not present in animal sources. Okay, here we have completed water soluble vitamins also. Then in very next lecture we will see minerals. Thank you very much.